Okay, we're on Zevachim Parakeh Mishnah Bet, second Mishnah, in the fifth chapter of Masechet Zevachim. We're continuing with our study of the places where the slaughter and the processing of the korbanot happened. Actually, technically, how they brought the korbanot. Parima nisrafim usi'irim nisrafim. So the cows that were burned, usi'ir, and the goats that were burned, meaning the par he'elam davar, par kor mashiach, these par he'elam davar, the par that's offered when the community, when the Sanhedrin forgot a halacha, and the par offered by the Kohen Mashiach, the Kohen Gadol, she'ein echalim lekohanim ele nisrafim chutz Yerushalayim. They're not eaten, they're burned outside of Yerushalayim. We'll see. So how are they offered? Shechitatam betzafon. Their slaughtering is also, we said, in the tzafon. Let's go back to our picture. Just to remind you what's a tzafon. Remember, this is the Mizbeach. This is the north, south, west, east. Okay? And it's offered in the north of the Mizbeach. Like above, like, you know, next to the Mizbeach, as it were. If you're walking in, it's in this area where the Beit HaMitbachayim is. Let's just make it a little bit bigger. This is a very, very big Beit HaMitbachayim. Mitbachayim is slaughtering from Tevach, from Zevachim. Tevach, Zevach. Okay, so it was done in the north. And they learned it from Sukkim. Mishnah continues, V'kibul daman v'kli sharei betzafon. And the catching of the blood was in holy vessels in the north. And also their blood was also sprinkled, not on the parochet, but also they would go into the Kodesh Kadashim, sprinkled in the Kodesh Kadashim. I don't know if you go into the Kodesh Kadashim, but he would go into the Lifnei Hashem et Pnei Parochet HaKodesh. Stand before God et Pnei towards the parochet. I don't think he went into the Kodesh Kadashim. He stood in the Azara and he sprinkled towards the parochet. I'm not sure about that. If you know for sure, email me. Also, they sprinkled it on the golden altar inside the Min HaMikdash. I never showed you where the Mizbach HaZahav is, right? In the Heichal, this is the Parochet. You're sprinkling, this is the Mizbach HaZahav, the small Mizbeach, the small altar that their incense was normally offered on. Matana achat behem me'akev, and one sprinkling is me'akev, is required in order to bring kapahara. The rest of the blood that was left was poured on the foundation, the yesod, on the western foundation of the outside mizbeach. And if he didn't do it for whatever reason, but they did, lo ikev, it was not ma'akev, it didn't hold back the kapara, the atonement. And the Mishnah says elu ve'elu nisrafim bebeit hadashen, both the par of Yom Kippur and anything else that's burned. Okay, we're burned to beta deshen. Deshen is the ashes in the house of ashes, i.e. they had a special place. The makom shemotzim shamet hadeshen sham mizbeach achitzon. They would burn off the korban. No, that'd be burned on the mizbeach, and they would take the ashes to this special place. Okay, because it says ve'otziat hadeshen mechutz machaneh, and parim nisfim, it says el shefech deshe yisareif, the place of the pouring of the deshen of the ashes. That's where they burn these parim that were called parim hanisrafim, the burned parim. We'll stop here, dedicate our learning, as we always do, to the memory of my father, Harav Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. Make it a great day.